Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Gfinity's UK CSGO Championship from London, England. I am Richard Lewis, your host for this event, and it's great to be back in the casting chair as well as the hosting chair. More about that later. But with me, we have got two of the UK's premier casters as well for this UK ensemble. We've got Kyanite on the end there and Banks closest to me. And of course, we did coordinate not to wear glasses today. Then you can tell us apart, right? Which is what we want. So how are you guys doing?
Very well. Looking forward to this. Another bit of UK CS action. It's good to see Gfinity still helping out and helping raise the UK up.
How are you, Kyle?
Yeah, I'm doing all right, Rich. I'm doing all right, most importantly. How are you?
I'm great. Yeah, I'm loving it.
As long as you're doing well, I'm doing all right, mate.
What I like about this exchange is, okay, so in rehearsal, he goes, I'm just recovering from the rain. what does that mean?
I knew that was coming.
Yeah,
just
of course
looking,
it's
just
like,
on your
it's
face.
It's one of the most ridiculous things I've ever heard. Like, just, I don't know, you're depressed, you know, you might have SADS, I don't know, mate. We'll get into that later. I'll diagnose you, mate. We'll sort that out.
Dr. Lewis.
Anyway, you're absolutely right. I am looking forward to this today. It's going to be a sort of cavalcade of everything that's good about UKCS. It is still there. There is still a scene. Mm-hmm. And Gfinity are doing all they can to sort of support it and encourage teams to sort of come together. And indeed, in this competition, we started with 46 teams, and which is pretty good going.
Yeah.
And we've whittled it down to the final 16, where they're going to be competing for a share of £5,000. Anyway, we can show you the bracket now. Immediately, there will be some teams there I'm going to guess you guys haven't heard of if you're watching the broadcast.
Yeah. But typical UK.
If you guys could just pick out some of the bigger names and tell us a little bit about them there.
Well, I think straight away we've got to look back at Epic Land, just took place recently. Choke Gaming came away with the winner. That you can see them at the top of the bracket. It's very likely that we're going to see them kind of breeze through the bracket, but Too Sexy being their first game. Too Sexy is a team we do actually commentate quite a lot in the UK, probably one of the more stable teams. But they have quite a wide level of like players they can choose from, quite a big roster generally.
Yeah.
We've also got Kaz Esports. They came second Epic Land recently. They have changed out a player though, so it'll be interesting to see what that and how that affects them. And obviously we've got Easy Skins now, the team at the moment being spoke about, a salaried team. And then Team Infused, which has always had a stable UK team. But again, just kind of the general census here for UK teams is we cannot keep them to stick to a five-man roster.
Mm. Yeah, and again, like in rehearsals, we actually mentioned Easy Skins. There's so much pressure on them to perform as well. You know, new salaried UK team. They've got players like Rattlesnake as well. So experienced, won CGS, you know. You look at Rattlesnake back in CS Source, find articles and articles written about him. Yeah. As well, Weber, one of unarguably the best players in the UK scene as well. So much pressure on these guys to perform. And I don't know, I'm really looking forward to this championship because this is actually the first time I actually see this team in action, particularly under the Easy Skins flag. So I'm
looking
forward to
it. There's a lot of pressure on them as well.
Yeah, exactly.
Especially at the moment because like a team in the UK looking to get salaried has been a thing that they've all been trying to do, all trying to work towards. They've been given this fantastic opportunity. Now it's their time to prove that UK's still here and that we can still compete. And there's so much potential here in CSGO. It's still growing on a daily basis.
And of course, Team Infused in there as well. They've been steady supporters of the UK Counter-Strike scene for as long as I can remember. I used to be a manager over in Infused after I left Zed Board, so you're probably talking about 2008 or something ridiculous like that. But yeah, they always made a point of sort of supporting UK gamers, and they've had some pretty good Counter-Strike teams down the years. What do we feel about where they're positioned at the moment?
I think they've got huge potential as a team. They have kind of stuck together with a small core lineup, haven't they? But it's what they haven't managed to do is make any notable results. We saw them last year in August. They were here at G3. Now they put up some great results. We saw some close games. But again, more roster changes happen.
Yeah.
Things fall apart and teams disband or players just don't have the motivation to play. We just need to find five core people for that team and they could be really good. It's going to really depend on how they're going to kind of play against the bigger teams like Easy Skins and Choke, because they've kind of jumped in now and just overtaken Infused, if you ask me.
Yeah, well, yeah, I agree. It's if you throw money at a problem, you can generally fix it. And speaking about money, let's bring up the prize fund for you guys at home so you can see exactly what the team's going to be competing for. So there you go. £2,500, nothing to be sneezed at there for the champions. Runners-up will get £1,500, and third and fourth will divide £500 each. Now, the best part about this, in my opinion, and perhaps what a lot of the organisations are looking at, are that the grand final of this UK Championship is going to take place, of course, at EGX, this huge event that Gfinity are running. So in terms of exposure and an opportunity to sort of show what you're capable of, and maybe reach a bigger audience, a broader audience, earn a bit of respect from some of the sneering CSGO fans out there that think UKCS is dead, that's a huge opportunity right there.
Yeah, I feel like having it at EGX, this day is no bigger platform to be on a grand final stage for. And this is a big deal for the UK scene. And whoever walks away with that is probably going to be looking at a nice, not just the prize pool money, but say the sponsorship side of things, showing what the UK is capable of. So, it's going to be a nice opportunity for all of them.
And what makes it particularly interesting is just talking about Easy Skins briefly. I do know, I don't know if you know, I know this guy called Henry G. Who
Heard of him? Yeah, he's all right.
but anyway, he was explaining to me how what he's done is he didn't want to make the same old mistake that a lot of people who've supported UK teams in the past is. And that's basically say to the players, right, there's your salary. You get on with it, and then 2-3 months down the road, they're like, yeah, this is a disaster. We're just throwing money into the bottomless pit. So what he's actually got those guys on is a performance-related salary. If you win tournaments, it goes up. Your salary gets increased. You win a major tournament, not a major, but a big one, a sizable one. I think that's a bit of a stretch to do
UK,
a major.
Yeah.
You know, we get more money. So, of course, things like that are exactly what they need to be aiming if they want to realistically achieve that. So it'll be interesting to see if that incentivizes them. But anyway, we're going to be talking about Infused versus Radical Esports first of all. Just a quick few words. We talked already about Infused, but a quick few words about Radical. I'm not going to lie. I'm never going to phone it in. Not too familiar with this team.
No, I think we looked down the list of names. We may pick out one, two players that you might have an idea of who they are. But considering how much UKCS, me and Kyle Knight cast, you generally can't look at this and go, yeah, no, not really. No full idea.
I was talking to Red Eye as well, and Red Eye always likes to talk about his matchmaking. He does bring that up on occasion. And he was saying that he played with some of these guys in his rank, which, you know, I don't know.
Says it all, really.
Yeah, I don't know.
I
don't know where that is. I don't know what level of Golden Over it is. No, I'm kidding.
Silver Four.
He's going to come up here now.
Yeah, he'll come up here and fire me if I keep talking about his rank. He's a legendary Eagle Master or whatever they call it.
Respectable.
He's got the badge on his
still
shirt.
Still higher than
shirt.
Fair play, Red Eye. Fair play. He's DMG, so you're not doing that bad.
Wait a second.
Legendary Eagle Virgin or whatever it is. I forget. But anyway, so just... Probably can say that Radical Esports aren't world beaters, that they are going to have a tough time here against Infused. But one of the great things about tournaments like this is you are in the shop window, so to speak. You have got an opportunity, even on an individual level, if you put in a good performance, you can always cite that as a reason why you're an upcoming talent.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do is we're going to take a quick look at the maps that we're going to have for this best of three. And you can see on your screens, it's going to be a pick of Mirage from Infused. Radical Esports have decided to go with Cash, and then should the decider be required, I think that's unlikely, but should one be required, we will go to Overpass. So three speciality maps here. Anyway, it is going to be me and James that are going to start the casting, so I might have to get back into this. But anyway, thanks a lot for your thoughts, Kai Knight. You're going to come back a little bit later and tag me in when I make a fool of myself. And we'll see you in a bit. But we're going to be getting into the game now. And we're still just doing the warm-up.
Yeah, I think here, like we were talking about this before the game, UK teams, Dust2 and Inferno, Cash and Mirage, always. We haven't seen a Dust2. That's made me happy to start off with in the best of three. And I'd love to see Overpass played. But realistically, going up against Infused, Radical's going to have to pull out something pretty special to make that happen.
Yeah, I mean, what I will say is, I do know Critical... from way back in the day, he's still trying, isn't he?
Pushing forward to make this work.
Yeah, I mean, but ultimately, you know, the one thing I'll say about him he's been a much maligned figure in UK CS down the years. But what I will say about him is he is a good tactician when he's on his game, when he's thinking about things, and when he is capable of sort of having time to sit down with a team, a stable lineup, and actually put some strats together. So I think it's good to see that they aren't just relying on the whole Dust2 and Inferno strats that UK's always relied on. Those were like, look, we'll play you on that, and we'll just out-aim you. And that was pretty much how we always used to get through games against better opponents. Now you can see that Team Infuse are going to be playing more speciality maps. And here, you know, Mirage is definitely one of those. It's not something you can just run around. You've got to have a very good coordinated CT side. The executes on the T side have got to be perfect. You know, if you want to get up on that A site especially, very easy to hold. So it's going to be interesting to see just how well drilled Infused are, even though I think they're not going to get too much of a test here from Radical Esports.
No, and I think you touched on Critical there as well. And I think with him, having someone very experienced like him in a team, it's always going to help raise a team up. And I think if he can stay calm and he can stay cool and collected, he will be able to kind of keep the team focused and make sure they stick to their game. But saying that, we know he's a very emotional player, 100%. And
yeah,
if Radical can get in his head or things don't start going there well, it can easily spiral the other way. And on a map like Mirage, which is so based on mid control, there's a potential here that Radical could kind of really push him right to the very end.
Yeah, I mean, I think you're definitely right. I think one of the things that will play a factor in this is going to be, you know, how mentally stable they can sort of stay in Infused, because they have got a couple of sort of firebrands in there, Critical being the obvious one. He's somebody that he was always very easy back in the day to put on tilt. If he started to feel that his team around him were maybe letting him down, not listening to his calls, or in particular if he was getting consistently out-aimed by somebody else, he would really sort of, you know, he would go until he'd get very angry, get very aggressive with the opponents. And that was something that's notorious. I mean, you can go on YouTube right now and find footage of him at Epic LAN, I think when he was playing for Fragmasters back in Source. And he's offering someone outside after a game.
That's pretty standard, isn't it?
I mean, don't get me wrong, that's just another day in the UK scene, right? But, like, he's a super emotional guy and always wants to win. When I was captain of the UK clan base nations team
years ago now.
I know, it's incredible, a long time ago, but Critical was my main guy. Like, he was the guy that I picked to sort of captain the whole lineup, and sort of, you know, I'd be like, look, in game you're my dude, you're my captain. Yeah, kind of like Alex Ferguson with like Roy Keane, you know what I mean? So he is a firebrand, but he is a very, very good tactician. He's very good at marshalling the troops, so really looking forward to seeing what we can do here. We are going to go into this knife round. Now, obviously, I don't cast knife rounds. I don't really like knife rounds, Banks. I'm not going to lie to you, mate.
I think it's just, yeah, it's more.
Can we just flip a coin now?
Yeah, just let it happen.
Yeah, can we just let that happen, please? It's not Gfinity's fault.
I think any good team, they should be prepared for either half, whichever one they start on. I think it's just all it's to do with is the mental game now. That's it.
So you can see we've had first blood drawn. One apiece. We've got some elevated shanking going on there, and Radical looking good here in the choke points, and there you go.
Come from behind.
NBP picks up three kills, and what are they going to do? They're just going to ready up and stay there on the T side. So we'll be going into the all-important pistol round and see if they can set up, get themselves a platform to win a few rounds, and we'll see how that's going to pan out. Worth mentioning as well, Windansky has just joined, so they have got a roster change. They have got a new player in there. And, of course, Aaron, old school. Like, he's close to my age, dude.
That's saying something.
Yeah, and that's ancient school. But he was one of the original 1.6 legends in the game back in the days when we had, like, Manja Capra and Harriman. So the game is going live, so you can see it looks like we're going to be moving over to that A side here for Team Infused, and Radical are just moving around. They're just spotting.
I think Infused here, it's always A site is such a favoured site here, but Radical's got a nice setup already.
And there's the first kill from Critical, jumping down with that Tech 9. Ooh. And then, an embarrassing team kill from Robin on Hunger, so not the start they wanted. Perhaps they were still drinking the night before. Windansky's just going to crouch, pick up that kill on Robin. Things looking very good here for Infuse. Campbell spamming away through the smoke onto those boxes, and it's NBP trying to carry on his knife round form. They went for the shank there. He heard it coming. Zed's going to finish him off with the Glock. And Robin types oops, and oops indeed, Banks, because that pretty much cost them the pistol round there. I think they were always struggling. But when you start killing your own teammates, it's an uphill struggle.
Yeah, the smoke was in a bit of a bad position there, so I can understand why he managed to get that off, but it's never acceptable, never the way you want to start off a round in Fuse, going for a nice, simple A rush there, great placements of the smokes and stuff. And I think we're going to see this a lot from Team Infuse. They're just going to have that kind of maybe better map control. But now, obviously, we see the Scouts, AK, one AK in play, kind of standard setup. Infuse coming in with a first kill, and look at this. Cookie going and gets two straight away. Oh, and Aaron with another. They're going to make it onto the A-bomb site once again. MVP here, though. He's trying to come from behind. We've got Campbell there as well. And they're just going to get shut down one by one. It's only one member left for Radical. And Team Infuse going to kind of take this comfortably. They've not spent big money as well, so going to be in their favor here. Let's see if NBP can do anything sneaking around.
Yeah, he just probably wants to try and get an exit here, try and take a gun. He has got the P250, so might be able to pick someone up here, but no, Zed's going to spot him, and it's going to be a comfortable 2-0 to Infused. So
a nice standard round from Infused, just what you'd expect, really.
Yeah, I mean, they didn't even really need to use that scout or anything there. It was just fairly straightforward. Walked onto A site with that SMG, with the, and it was just two easy kills, and Bob's your uncle. So
what's interesting here, though, for Radical, they've not really done anything particular, not brought up any nades, not tried to any forces. They're kind of playing it standard, just going out with a pistol. It's got one P250, that's it. Cookie, again, gone very fast onto this A-bomb. So he does get taken down by Robin, though. So it's just one for one trade. They're going to see if they can try and get that gun here. But look at Critical with the Rec 9. Gets one. Windansky takes the second. Tries to get a third there. He's got the AK out. And, well, nicely done. They're just going to clean it up. Very simple here. It's going to be all up to Campbell. When you get shut down by Zed as Infused, pick up the 3-0 as expected.
Yeah, and what they did there is, I mean, it just shows sort of the superiority. Infuse kind of walked into the stack. They actually were read by Radical. Radical weren't able to do anything to shut them down. They were right. They weren't buying nades. They weren't really doing anything. We have got this AWP out, so it's going to be Campbell who's going to be AWPing for Radical. Big responsibility on his shoulders. Because he's about to go into this window room. And is he going to get the pick through the smoke? No, he did get just on the top of him, but kind of whiffed it a little bit. So you can see Infused once again. Cookie Monster's just walked up here, but actually wasn't able to do anything. Hunger's going to shut him down. So that's a very good start to the round for Radical. And that's what they need to do here on the CT side. Windansky's managed to wrap around now. He's going to be coming in the connector. Well, he shouldn't have got away with that, but he has. He's been able to take down Campbell, who sort of missed a shot at point blank range. And is that going to open up the bomb site now? But it looks like the bomb is going to be taking that long rotate round to A through that spawn point. So
you can see Radical just under a lot of pressure right now, just how they're positioning themselves. Hunger's checking through, jumping around, making quite a bit of noise here. Is he going to be able to do it? He's going to hold up on the ramp. There's going to be a good position here. It's all going to be about timing for Infuse right now. And look at that. Zed gets one critical onto another. They're going to go straight to the A-bomb, so only two members left for Radical already. Robin comes round, but Critical with the scout does manage to finish him off. It's all up to MVP once again, and he's going to save. It's just the only smart decision here, but it doesn't even get away with that. Gets shut down by Windansky, and 4-0 for Infuse. But the thing that really confused me there is how Cookie managed to get into the A bomb site right at the beginning without even being spotted for ages.
Well, you can see Radical struggling there with the CT setup. Cookie Monster able to just literally walk up that A ramp without even being spotted by anyone in jungle. He did get taken down. That gave them a good start, actually, Radical. But then we saw the same problem happen in connector. And Windansky was just able to walk up into connector and get a kill. Walked right past Campbell to get that kill.
But this is more like it right now. Look at Aaron, comes out there, deals with Radical. They had walked up some few pistols. We had a few 5.7s in play. Team Infused are making light work of it, but look, Campbell's got himself hold of an AK-47. We were just talking about them buying up a little bit more, trying to make use of it. This is exactly what they needed to do, just to give them a bit more of a fighting chance, really, and take some weapons, take some money down from Infused, especially with a 4-0 up right now.
Well, they tried a little push there through Palace. It didn't come off. I mean, Infused are playing this very intelligently. They are spread out around the map. They're confident to take in the duels, which they should be. And Campbell needs to hold on to this AK, just try and get the economy rolling. But this is going to be Infused round. He might get a kill here. Oh, that's embarrassing. That's embarrassing there for Campbell. No way Zed should be getting that kill. And you can see the superiority in the players right there. That's a terrible manifestation of...
He must have been able to hear it as well. He just shouldn't have fluffed that.
Exactly. He just fluffed it. I mean, don't get me wrong. Sure, Zed did jump around that corner, but You've got to make that 10 times out of 10. Anyway, it is going to be 5-0 to Infused, and we got a slow execute here. Critical with the scout. So.
Still, he's got like 13k, and he's just laughing with that scout right now.
Well, I mean, of course, we do know the scout is so powerful in this. And we've got Campbell coming in. He's going to get one. He's going to get two. Nice. That's a nice little headshot there. So that is perhaps going to give Radical what they need to maybe take the first round. When Dansky's going to answer back immediately, we have got a 3-on-3 situation now. And Cookie Monster's going to take down Quig. So all of a sudden, that man advantage is over for Radical. And Robin's trying to do what he can here with the Famous at the back of the bomb site. He's going to be spamming around in the meantime. Windansky's taking down MVP. And once again, what looked to be a good situation ends with an absolute horror show.
And that was actually a great situation for Radical there. Taking down Critical and Aaron, two of the key players really from the lineup straight away, going out there aggressively and not being able to hold that from there. Should have really been a bit better, to be fair, from Radical.
And you can see the players were typing there about stream delay, so Infused were actually distracted.
Yeah, and focused on other matters.
Radical not able to do anything. Anyway, that is the end of Critical Scout. They're now just going to go for these 5 AK. So no AWP being brought out from Critical. And well, that's a nice little one bullet there from Hunger to take down Aaron, but Cookie Monster's going to answer back. And again, Cookie Monster just walking up this ramp. No fear in it right now, and they're not able to shut him down even on these forced buy rounds. And you can see that Hunger's going to use that AK and take down Cookie Monster. Critical's going to answer back on Hunger. It's going to be a 2-on-3. Robin there with the Swag 7. So a lot of pressure here for MVP. P isn't able to do anything, and Robin spamming away down to 1 HP, just trying to get a kill. He does get a headshot on the Critical, so it is a one-on-one. I heavily favor Zed here, I think.
Yeah, Zed in a very good position. Robin right now still only got the Mag 7. He's not even got an AK or an M4 in his hands, and that would be the only ideal situation he could hope for right now. Zed playing it smart, falling back into CT. And
yeah, he's not taking any risks.
No. I mean,
he won't know that it's exactly 1 HP. He'll know he's low, but you have just got to go through the motions here. But as soon as he sees him, he's going to kill him. It's going to be 7-0 to Infused, and Radical are really struggling here on this CT side. I'll ask you, James, and I mean, there's not really anything that you can sort of do in this position, because I wouldn't say Infused are even necessarily executing any tactics here.
It's just
here.
Split, pick, and abuse right now.
Yeah, exactly. Radical definitely need to get to grips with this A bomb site, because it's too easy right now.
Yeah, Cookie walks up this ramp pretty much every round. Look, he spotted one there, but he does get taken Hunger's down. So this is out. The start they need. Hunger, they're getting a nice shot straight through that smoke onto Cookie as he comes up. And now it's all going to be about how Radical deal with this. They can't falter, and they can't get put off. They've got to use this to their advantage. And once again, they all just fall back out of position. Critical onto MVP. It's going to be happening towards the B bomb site. One of the first times we've been here so far. Robin can't quite manage it. Zed does get the better of him. And Hunger, oh, wow, shot down straight away. It's all going to be up to two members now of Radical. They're still holding it, though. And then Windansky, he's coming around slowly.
It's a 2-on-1 in favor of Radical. This should be Radical's first round, but Windansky nearly got that headshot there. Campbell is going to pick it up. We have got a round on the board for Radical. And Infuse changed up their tactics, decided to go to the B bomb site. Didn't work out for them. If it isn't broken, don't fix it. But I've got to say, what I think did make the big difference there was, for once, Cookie Monster wasn't able to just walk up that ramp. They put the smoke down. It wasn't a perfect smoke. Cookie Monster actually did get vision on Hunger, first of all. But then he was able to get the kill, and that set them up for the round, the CTs. So another slow A execute. You can see back to business as usual, yeah, and just absolutely decimating their numbers down with this ramp and connector push. So NBP is having to come from this B bomb site. Might be able to get a kill here. He has been spotted, but he does get the kill on the Critical. That's going to give him the call, and you can see that he's getting flanked right now by Zed. I don't know if he knows he's there. Well, ooh, that flash is going to save his life, but I think it's a temporary reprieve from being on death row. Infuse is just hunting him down, and Windansky's going to get the kill. 8-1, and again, back to that A side execute. Radical Esports just haven't got to grips with that right now.
I think what it is for Infuse, the tactic they're playing is, if Cookie gets a kill in A, we'll go for it.
Yeah.
If he doesn't, we're going B. And sadly, they lost the B round that time. But 8-1 right now, and Radical can be under a hell of a lot of pressure. There's a fair little bit of talk going on right now as well.
So you can see, yep, we've had a slight pause. I think this is while they are fixing
The delay, yeah.
Yeah, the delay. It's just to make sure there's no stream sniping, which, to be honest, if I was Radical, I would have been getting someone to do that right now. The depressing thing would be if they were stream sniping and still getting absolutely battered. Yeah, that would have been all kinds of awkward, but you can see.
Just look at the money of Infuse. Obviously, losing one round, countering it straight away. Radical haven't been able to build up any sort of bank balance at all right now, where the T's, they're looking very comfortable. And again, we've got to point out that I talk about the mid control on this map so much between the top teams. Critical with an AWP. No, he doesn't even have that. Just using AK. Doesn't even need to right now. And again, Cookie onto just, the A-bomb side.
Yeah, again, just walking up through Palace, gets that pick. And what they're doing is so well here in Fused. And it's just what Radical haven't got to grips with. Even on the, you know, even on an eco round, you can still be in the right positions. And that is that they're walking through Connector and Ramp and Palace simultaneously. You're getting hit from three choke spots. There's absolutely nothing you can do to stop that unless you are able to out-aim your opponents. You've just got to stop them getting there. And I don't know, it's almost like they've given up mid and kind of just, they're really letting Infuse walk wherever they want right now. There doesn't seem to be any intelligence being gathered. There's no comms. There's no reconnaissance. No one's getting that info you need to even get an idea of what's coming.
And from Radical, there's a serious amount of they're not flashing. No anti-flashes, no defensive smokes, really. We've seen it maybe on one round, and probably the round they won. And once again, this time it's Aaron, comes up the ramp, takes advantage. Robin's going to get one here, though. Nice work with the P250. We'll try and go get Critical's gun there, but Windanski just running into CT spawn. You can see the confidence on Infuse right now. And the best hope for Radical every time is, I need to get a gun, I need to save it. And they're just going to be hunted.
Well, yeah, it was a double eco there as well. They are trying to get that economy going. I don't know if they've had a talk and thought, look, we just need some AWPs or something to try and shut them down. Hunger is going to get a kill on his head, but he's been taken down to 6 HP. It's a 2-on-1. No doubt that Infused are going to win this round. Bomb ticking away. We are going to see 10-1. I just can't see how Hunger's going to save this. He's given away his position. Here comes the nade. Ooh. He's thrown it. Oh, it is going to get him. And
you can never quite tell with them CSGO nades on the distances for them.
And Kui gives it the Kobe. It is going to be 10-1. So things looking really grim here for Radical. I can see now that they have picked up the AWP onto Campbell. So what's he going to do with it? Because they've just been giving mid away. And this is why Infuse has been literally able to walk down mid unchallenged, get into Connector, and all of a sudden the guys on A have got it all to do. But there you go. Critical's going to get took down by Campbell. That's the first thing he's really done in that mid area all game. Is that going to be enough for Radical to pick up this round? But once again, Windanski this time has just walked up that ramp and took down MVP. This is the problem site for Radical. And Infused are just decimating the Radical numbers. Hunger now is going to try and come through the jungle area. Isn't able to do anything. Windanski's there to greet him. The old Irish handshake. An AK bullet to the head. Quig is going to have to spare himself and just go and hide behind this van.
Do you know what? The thing here is Campbell, he had that AWP, came up with the first shot, got the kill, did what he needed to do, but it doesn't solve the problem that the A site is so lost right now. They're just in bad positions. They're out too far in the open. And Infuse are running around taking advantage. Quig did manage to take down one there, but they chased him down, got the kill.
Knew where he was straight away as well.
11 for 1, obvious position.
And they were just supremely competent in hunting him down. They weren't going to let him save that gun. I mean, at this point, you'd be like, look, this would just be just, it's a mercy killing. Just let them have something infused. Yeah. But now they are really superior here. And Radical, even when they're getting those first frags, they can't really convert it into any sort of measurable advantage. Here we go. We got a double scout by here with a FAMAS and a couple of pistols. So we're going for the jump scout at the back. Campbell's trying to do something with that. He's so far and he's got the one tag. And there we go. Robin's able to convert a kill onto Windanski. So the double scout has reaped dividends. That's nice. A nice little headshot there from the window dropping down. And all of a sudden, Hunger might be able to get another kill here. He is. So they have actually got a numerical advantage here, Radical. Cookie Monster and Zed trying to do the hide, and there's Cookie Monster does get one. So it's all on Zed. Robin and Hunger both at full HP. One with an AWP, one with the AK. I think Robin switched out to a FAMAS. So be able to pick that up later. Now, who's going to go for the defuse? Zed, this is actually a winnable clutch here. Smoke's gone down. He isn't able to get the kill. Have they got time for the defuse? They haven't got a kit. I don't think they've got this, you know.
Oh, God.
I don't think they have three.
No.
Yep.
And even then, Robin was absolutely fantastic that round with the scout. Better than he was with the AWP or anything else we've seen him use. But even then, it just wasn't enough.
Nah, and that's when you know it's going to be a bad day at the office. They managed to do a 4-scout buy. There's a Famas in there, a couple of pistols. And, yep, they can't. They get the kills. They do the hard part. Who's got the kit, lads? Sorry, I left that in my locker, mate. Yeah, round over. GG. 12-1 to win Fuse. And obviously, they're listening to the cast as well. Richard was right. I'm sorry, boys, if you're listening to this. I'll try and be more complimentary so you don't beat me up if I ever attend a UK event again. But Robin gets the opening kill on to Windansky. Good news for them. But again, as always, Infuse just come right back at them and take down 3 kills. So Critical's going to get that kill on Hunger on short. On Kui coming from that jungle area. Might be able to get one here. No, Critical's going to get the next kill. Maximum disrespect from him. 13-1. Do you think this one's in the books, Banks?
Well, to be the one thing I'm going to say straight away is, okay, it's 13-1 right now, but this is Infused map pick. Next map pick's going to be Radicals. But just look at the skill between both teams. Mm. There's no way this is going to be any different on the second map, and you can just tell that already. It's simply from the pure skill set of both teams. It's a major difference.
They might have something up their sleeve on cash. Who knows?
I'd be very, very, very hopeful right now, but once again, Cookie straight into that A-bomb site, and... Well, MVP's got himself in a good position, does get one. Can't finish off the second, though. Nice headshot from Windansky. Robin, though, once again, the man who's saving it right now with the scout. He's the only one who might be able to turn this around. He's shut down straight away by Aaron.
He's had some nice shots with the scout, though.
Yeah.
I'll definitely give him credit for that. Where most people are playing for the tag and they want their teammates to do the work, he's actually landing some really good headshots here. It's a one-on-two situation. Hunger at the back of... Oh, wow, he is going to get the kill. So he's pushed through that smoke somewhat randomly. I'm sure Critical won't be happy about that. And you see Hunger, I don't think he knows where the other guy is. He's going to try. He's put the smoke down. No kit again. Going to get taken down through the smoke. 14-1 at halftime. Fairly comprehensive. And, well, got to say, impressive from Team Infuse, but Radical didn't really offer any resistance on that A-bomb site at all.
No, it definitely comes down to the lack of using counter flashes, well-placed smokes, and just being a bit smarter on how they like position themselves in the A-bomb site. When you've got someone who then started, like Robin, doing so well at middle, in the A-bomb site, everyone was just letting everything falter and it didn't change anything.
Oof. Hello. Critical goes mid there and takes down Robin at maximum range with Sanchez B. But that's a nice little headshot there from Zed as well. Not to be outdone by his team captain. Hunger's going to take down Cookie Monster. Critical's going to get another kill. You can see Zed just tapping away. They have managed to get a plant here. Eric's going to shank Quig. They're going to get this defuse. It is going to be 15-1. And if it wasn't already an uphill battle, it definitely is now.
Yeah, we're going to see some shotguns and mag 7s, I'm guessing, and it's buy what you can and hope for the best situation. 15-1 a match point already, and yeah, they've literally just got to buy everything they can and see what they can do here against Infuse, but Robin, UK seem too strong.
Well, yeah, we've got a real variety of weapons on show here. Let's see what can happen. And there's Critical. He's going to get the tag with the scout. Wasn't able to get the second. He is going to get it at the third bite of the cherry. Going to take down Campbell. You can see Edge just facing him. Critical just jumping around. And it's like watching a budget MBK go to work. Windansky's going to get a couple of deagles as well. And MVP, once again, the last guy left alive. Can't do anything with a Tech 9. 16-1 to Team Infused. Hugely impressive start. But realistically, Radical outclassed in almost every department.
What was that budget MBK? I think that's the best thing I've heard for a while. That was the best way to put Critical down there.
I'm not putting him down. I mean, MBK does abuse the jump scout. So, you know, I'm sure if MBK was watching this, which I'm pretty confident he's not.
No.
But if he does, he'll appreciate that. It is an homage, as they say in France.
Well, first map 16-1. Very destructive there from Infused. And Radical, there was nothing they could do in that situation at all. They were just being out-aimed and they weren't playing it smart. They weren't reacting to anything else either. And it just wasn't acceptable at all.
Mm. You know, I kind of disagree. In the one sense, you're right. There is nothing they can do because they can't just suddenly elevate their skill. But equally, they didn't seem to really give themselves a fighting chance there. They didn't seem to understand the key components of what makes teams successful on Mirage. There was no mid control for starters. There was no mid control. Infuse literally walked down mid.
They tried at the very last few rounds. Robin tried, but he should have done that after round four.
It's like Campbell was just like, I'm not up for this.
No,
I really can't do it. He went there a couple of times with the AWP. Wasn't really able to hold it. They just didn't look familiar at all in sort of how important mid control is on a map like Mirage. They were by contrast as well over on the B site. They're playing that quite smart, quite intelligently. But Infuse don't need to go there. They don't need to go there at all. So you've actually got this situation where they're playing super passive on the A site. So they're letting them walk up ramp while simultaneously letting them walk down mid into connector. You just can't. Maybe you get away with one if you're a good team. Maybe you get away with one. You don't get away with both.
And the only round they got was on when they hit the B bomb site at that time when things faltered at A. But to Cash.
Yeah. Anyway, on to Cash. Look, that's not look too glum, mate.
I expected a little bit more from Radical. That's all I'm saying.
Let's have a friendly bet. I bet Radical are going to get at least two rounds on this.
At least two rounds.
At least two rounds. So there you go. But what we are going to do, James and Kainite, we haven't forgot about you, mate. He's just he's got nowhere to go.
I'm not sure.
It's all right. We are going to go to a short break, and when we come back, we're going to bring you the second map in this series. It's going to be Infuse versus Radical Esports on Cash. We'll see you very soon.
I'm on it. We'll be right back.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Gfinity UK CSGO Championship. We're in the middle of a titanic match. It's so close. It's back and forth. No, it's not. It's Infuse just beat Radical Esports on the first map, 16-1. They're about to go on to the second map, Cash. With me is Banks and Kyanite. We didn't talk to you much, Kyanite, in that last bit. You just sort of loitered, like, talk to me.
I sort of became Noddenite. Yeah.
So you did watch the game. You got any advice for Radical?
Well, this is meant to be their map now. But the problem is that Cash is actually a map that historically Team Infused are very good on as well. Especially once Critical starts going berserk with his AWP. So expect when Team Infused are on the CT side for Critical to go absolutely ham at mid. Sometimes switch it round to the B bomb site as well. Sometimes hide at MBK. His AWP is going to be a crucial part of the Infused defense here for them. And I honestly think if Radical can maybe start on their more favored side, it might help them. But I still think this is going to be a 2-0, as we really predicted. It's just individual. The problem here, not just tactically, the Infused players are just on a completely different level.
Well, you can see this knife round is kind of like
a runaway.
Yeah, it's almost like a metaphor for the first game, in a sense that it was just Infused running at them. The only difference here is Radical might have a chance of winning this. So we're going to see.
Radical took the knife the first round.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, they're decent at knives, they're competitive at knives, but it is going to be Infused that win that one. Of course, no one's going to change. They just want to get into the game. So we're going to have this all-important pistol round very shortly. You can see that Infused is going to be starting on the CT side of Cash. Good opportunity for them to build up a solid lead. Not that I think they're going to need it. And Radical Esports is going to be on the T side. So the have fun. I'm sure Infused are having fun.
Massively.
And sadly, it's at the expense of Radical. Let's see what's going to happen anyway. So, actually, looks like they're just going to try and wolf pack into A here. Once again, no smokes, no flashes. This isn't an execute. They're just running in there. And that's not what you want to do against Infuse, because if you take the 1v1 jewels, you're going to come off worse. Aaron's going to get that first kill. MBK's going to... MBK.
See, now you got it stuck.
Now it's there. It's locked in my head. We need to bring MBK in as a merc for Radical. Anyway. They have managed to get this bomb down here. It is ticking away, but you can see Windansky there with a double headshot somehow.
Nice.
Cookie's going to pick up another, and Windansky's going to get it. Great little retake there. And well played to Radical for getting the bomb down. But, pretty easy on the retake there. Windansky with the 3 kills.
I feel a little bit sorry for Radical as well, because they're probably going to be feeling pretty demotivated after the first game. And to come back into it, they'd ideally would needed that pistol round in any situation, but even more so for this game. And Infused, we're going to see him obviously look shotguns in play, Vizen, 1M4, Scout as well. It's going to be Infused having a bit of fun here, and we're just going for the standard Glocks again. This is exactly what I didn't like seeing from Radical.
Infused still need to unlock a few achievements, mate. That's what's going on. So anyway, there we are. Absolute butchery in the middle. The auto shot, you're doing some work, Robin.
He's having a spot of
it. He's having a left click, and Zed's going to get the kill in the shank off. He was saying, let's do it for Scotland. Well, it's kind of like the football.
Oh.
Didn't work out for them that time. So, but because of that first round plant,
they will get the surprise by Cheeky.
I don't think it's going to be much of a surprise for Infused, but they haven't kept those SMGs. They have bought actual guns. You can see the M4s and an auto sniper there from Cookie Monster. Critical with the scout again. He's going to jump. He's going to get that tag. Robin really low as a result of that. And the auto sniper's there from Cookie. And so far, Radical, they're just taking these 1v1 duels. They've got to stop doing it. They need to group up and try and use the weight of numbers to get plants and force the issue. Anyway, they're down here. You can see Queeg and Robin are the walking wounded. Big responsibility on Hunger's shoulders. He's going to have to try and do something. And he's looking at his AK while he's flashed. And he just gets killed as Aaron pushes through that smoke. That's not only going to give him the kill, it's going to give him the intel as to where the other two are. And you can see 64 HP between the two remaining members of Radical going up against 4 members of Infused in very good states of repair. Here comes the boost. Is Robin able to do anything here? Going into that mid area, he's having a little look around. So that's it, Robin. You can't even fall too far, mate.
He's going to be careful.
Fragile as Kyanite. The rain's going to get him.
This is just going to be a hold and try save without getting pushed here. They're very close to each other, though, with Windansky from Robin being on his left. Ooh, did he not see him?
Should have gone to spec savers, mate. So, yeah. Well, Windansky's going to definitely know where he is now. And Robin, I don't even know what he's trying to do here.
He just wants to stay alive, yeah. Rich. He doesn't want to die right now.
In the meantime, Queeg has been wrecked by Zed with that AWP. So Robin on 12 HP, just trying to save his AK. It's going to all be a bit comical here. I'm pretty sure Infused are just going to chase him down. And are they going to get to him in time? No. So Robin does save the AK. But I think that shows the contrasting fortunes here of both teams. You know, Radical Esports are having to work incredibly hard just to save a gun at the end of the round. And Infused, of course, on the easier side of the map. They're just sitting pretty right now.
Well, once again, we've seen actually a nice play here from Radical started, at least buying some Tech-9s. Got Robins, who did manage to save his AK. But can they make any use of it? Not with Cookie, with that auto-sniper. Does away with him. Zed also gets one critical with the scout shot, and all up to Robin again, and he's left in a very tricky situation. Going to be running around and seeing who he can divert from, but Windansky chases him down, and Infused just got full confidence on this map control and just running around, popping heads as they go.
Well, yeah, they just walked into a shooting gallery there, and you know, bad call tactically, because they should have known from previous rounds exactly how they were set up. You know, that Cookie Monster was waiting for them there with the auto sniper, you know, and Critical's there with the scout. You know, you combine those two and you're just running at them with like no flashes again, poor executes. You know, it's only going to end one way. So Radical are now on an eco, and Cookie Monster just having a little look over the top there. Critical's fallen back from highway. Just getting ready for that A push as a result of the intel that Cookie Monster was able to ascertain. Aaron just spamming away with a deagle.
It comes back to what I say on the reactiveness of last game. They're seeing what Infuse are doing, but they're not trying anything different. They're just sticking to their guns, and it's going to be a spray down here. Aaron with three, gets the deagle out, does get another. Will he go for the ace? It's only Robin who's got to be dealt with. He's spamming away that P250, but Cookie comes in and finishes him off with the Rec 9. 5-0 for Infused, and Radical Esports running to their death at the moment, aren't they? Just running into bullets.
Lambs to the slaughter. I mean, just to put that into some sort of perspective here, they ran out of the squeaky door. Aaron wasn't expecting that. He had his gun sort of half-changed. Got the spray down, runs out of bullets, has time to switch to the deagle, and it's just one tapping with a deagle, and they're still not even to take him down when they've got those Tech-9 pistols.
Ooh,
so
Campbell, though, does manage to get the better of him. Take round one. Cookie goes down, but it's going to be up to him and Critical. And Critical can get him with this scout. It's going to put him in a good position, but he does get legged down to 16 health. And well, let's see if Radical can make anything of it. The auto sniper's in the hands of Windansky. And an achievement has been earned, as you were saying, Rich.
There you go.
It's achievement time for Team Infused.
People thought I was joking. Achievement to a serious business in the pro scene.
And it's like once they get started, no, Campbell just there getting a second shot, but they've got to make a bit faster action here. They're being chased down by Windansky, and this could be over in seconds.
Well, we'll see. It's, Windansky's going for the shank. Is he going to get it? Well, he's left clicking,
what?
And Campbell's going to get the kill. All of a sudden, it's on a 2v2 again. Max with disrespect, but it might prove costly here. Hunger has put them in a good position to get the round here by taking down Critical. And you can see that Aaron with it all to do. Campbell's going to pick up another kill. And in the end, that knife from Windansky proved costly.
Yeah, he was sneaking round, and it looked very dangerous there. But luckily, he decided to left-click, and we got away with that one for Radical to take the round.
And you can see Robin joking there, saying Campbell just earned himself a promotion. Congratulations on the promotion, mate. Looking forward to the party for it. So, Radical, do pick up another round. Now, remember my bet, right? And I'm hoping Radical, if they are indeed listening to the stream, which it seems that they are, perhaps you might want to turn the stream off and concentrate on the game, lads. But anyway, if they can get two rounds, once again, my predictions have been supremely accurate there. So, we have had the trade kill. Campbell's has been taken down there by Critical again in that mid area. The double AWP set up here, and Robin and MVP have now created a 4-on-2 situation for Radical. So Critical's just sat in a good spot here. He knows one's gone underneath him. He's going to call that to his teammates. He's waiting for the next one to come. He does pick him off with the AWP.
Nice.
And all of a sudden, Critical's got two. That's just great map awareness from the veteran. Great control and communication. All of a sudden, he's going to turn it around. He gets the leg onto him. And look at that, 4 kills from Critical. They had no right to win that round, but just really great spatial awareness.
That was the ace. That was Critical. That was the ace. He got the first one just peeking up on the box at middle there and took off his head as he got boosted.
Absolutely right. So incredible play from him. But again, it just shows, you know, that experience. It does go a long way.
Yeah, if that might have been one of the radical players, they might have jumped down and hunted for the first kill initially, but Critical played it so smart and managed to turn it around. And, well, once again here, from Critical, AWP shot onto Campbell. They don't have a full buy here, though, for the T side. And I think with Campbell dropping down, it's going to be putting him in another bad position, maybe knock their confidence. And look at this from Cookie, just spraying away.
A bit early for the negatives, isn't it, mate? It's a bit early for the Negevs.
Well, they're obviously feeling that confident that they want to get the rank up on that weapon. You need to get 200 kills a bit soon.
Yeah, honestly, I literally think they are going for the achievements here. I'm pretty sure about that. Quig's going to get another kill. It's going to be a 3-on-3. Historically, Radical haven't been able to win these situations. They get into the positions where, realistically, on the T side, they should be able to force the agenda. But then just a moment of individual skill from Infused really shuts the round down, but you can see they are.
No one at B at all here, but they are just closing in on them. There's only one place Radical can be.
Infused is pushing behind them all the time, and you can see Radical are so wary that they're going to get flanked every time that they're almost too scared to go on the bomb sites. But B is open for business. They should be able to get the plant here. Well, no, Critical's going to stop that. Great little quick peek and flick through the smoke. Isn't able to get the next one. And you can see Aaron's going to finish that off for him. Robin with it all to do, 1v3 with the AWP, and isn't able, whiffs that one, and Critical takes down Robin, 7-1 now to Infused.
You've got to have confidence to play Counter-Strike, and one thing that Infused have done to Radical is take all their confidence away from him, because Infused are just everywhere all the time and all over them.
Mm. Well, Robin's saying that he used to be good.
Believe me, please.
Well, when was that?
Yeah.
I've been around a while. I don't remember it, Robin. I think someone's telling Porky's.
Let's check with Thorin. We'll make sure we didn't miss anything.
I'm sure Thorin will have heard of these guys, won't he? Keep in mind, like Thorin says Nipperbad. What do you think he's going to say about these dudes? Anyway, another round seems to be going the way of Team Infused. And the knives are going on. Well, good. I'm sure there's a knife achievement that can be unlocked. Windanski's going to take down Campbell. It's good to see Windanski as well, because he used to do this a lot in Source, actually. He did used to use the Deagle. He was a really strong Deagle player in UK terms. And he seems to be picking up the Deagle again in CSGO, which is having a comeback into the meta recently.
Making a resurgence right now, for sure. For ages, everyone would just stay away from it. No point in trying to get that gun out. But 8-1 right now. Infused just ruling the way.
Yeah, well, you can see we got a scout, we got an AWP, we got a Tech 9, we got an AK and a Galil. So it's a variety box. Aaron's going to get the kill. Quig is going to take down Aaron, who'd been tanked by his own teammate then. MVP's going to get Zed. So come on, boys. Make my prediction come true. Cookie Monster, though, with a Deagle, is going to get the headshot on a Robin. And it is a 3-on-3. Critical has boosted up into that upper area. He's just sort of running along the railing. Going to drop down and go for the smoke. He's going to go aggressive with the AWP here. Isn't able to get the Quick Scope, but didn't cost him anything. Hasn't been penalized. Campbell is going to take down Cookie Monster, though. Windanski just having a little... He's working on his tan, sitting in the flames.
Dancing in the fire.
Yeah, doesn't even care. I don't need HP. Critical going to get taken down at Forklift. So Windanski now playing from the card, trying to do the long-range Deagle that we were just talking about. Even though he has got that M4. Bomb has been planted. Just looking for a headshot here. Boom.
He might be out of bullets in that M4, so he could do with getting another gun.
There it is. MVP is going to get that kill. The lads have done it. That's right, Critical. I won the bet. Thank you, Radical.
Radical have given you what you want.
That's all I needed. I can go home now. I'm done for the day. But two rounds. I mean, so far, not a terrible return. You can see the game is being played in a good spirit. They are having fun and enjoying it. But maybe Radical can get a platform to build on here and see what they're able to do. And you can see that we've got a couple of Deagles in here for Infused. Chance to really go three rounds. Oh, when they're doing that. I like it when they're doing, I like when they're doing the run boost.
The old Pubmaster style. Yeah. When Campbell come out aggressively, does get one onto Cookie, but straight away, he falls back, turns his back to another player coming out of him. Gets shot in the back down to 22 HP, and Critical's just going to look for him right now. Aaron obviously boosted up in a very good spot.
Well, this is a great boost. This is a really good boost. And you can see, no one's even going to check up there.
Nope.
So he's just going to be able to get easy kills. And look, you can't even call where that is. You're like, all right.
I died.
Guys, I've been killed. I don't even know where he is. Oh. MVP, trying to go for that long distance peak, isn't able to do anything. But again, it just shows how at home Infused are on this map as well, yeah. A point that was made by Kai and I. This isn't just about superiority in terms of individual aim and whatnot. They obviously understand the map, understand the mechanics of the game. They know how to get into good positions, as demonstrated by that booster.
Well, 9-2 right now, and well, Radical may have got two rounds so far, but again, back on the back foot with pistols in hand, one AK on MVP, and Windanski trying to flick around with that deagle, gets one, nice headshot with that. Oh, misses the second, and gets shot down by MVP. So he's going to be kicking himself for that one. MVP with a second kill as well. Does get, Critical gets a knife onto Robin. Critical gets two knives.
Double knife.
How does he manage to get two knives there? They're on low health, they're being forced back, but it's a two versus two, and then one goes down. It's going to be all up to MVP.
The double knife there for Critical. They must have been throwing knives.
Yeah, legit.
Valve, please.
Speed running to his next opponent. Four MVP, 16 health. Against two of the members left of Infused.
So, yeah, he's going to wait for those flames to dissipate. Might get the kill here. Probably should have done. And there you go. You can see, look, I don't have a rank as joining the terrorist force.
I needed backup.
Yeah, to be fair, mate, you'll fit right in on Radical if your name is true. You'll be right at home. MVP not able to get the kill, is going to get taken down at long distance. And it's 10 rounds to 2 now for Infused. So, well, this is Critical's out of his comfort zone. I think he was quickly tabbed onto his Steam and was like, what gun do I need achievement for next?
I need about 10 more kills with that. I'll pick that up. Brilliant.
So don't rule it out. We might see another achievement unlocked here. Again, it's going to be the Tech 9 and Scout by Radical. See if they can do anything with that. There's Critical straight in with that Negev. Gets edge on Robin. Of course, the bomb is down.
So he's got it. He's
pretty much won
it.
The round right there. He can just camp the bomb. And of course, he's up against an eco. And he's got about a billion bullets in that thing. So he should be okay.
And poor Quig, last man alive. He's managed to bag himself an M4. Best situation probably be to save it, but he's going to get hunted down. They're going to push around him. He's already got bullets fired at his back there. Does get finished off by Cookie, and 11-2 it's going to be. Fun guns are out on Team Infused.
Well, Red Eye did the commentator curse there. He's like, yeah, I think Hunger's...
pretty good.
Yeah, but Hunger's a decent player, I think. And he's on 1-12.
Oh, dear.
So I just want you to know, Hunger, with a 3, you've not just let yourself down.
Oh,
you've let Red Eye down. And there's Critical pushing again with the Negev. Just all the bullets, it doesn't matter. He's still shooting. We've gone to someone else. Zed's going to get the kill there onto Hunger. Having a terrible day at the office. Zed's going to pick up the double onto Robin. MVP once again, last man standing.
And he's all the way in A by himself.
And yep, the B in his name stands for bait. And it's going to be 12 rounds to 2. Head ripped off as he emerges from that squeaky door.
You know what Wendanski's doing now? Because we mentioned his deagle. He's just pulling out the deagle and having fun. He's like, how many nice shots can I get for them?
Well, no, what he's thinking is, now I might make a frag movie. He might use some of this commentary in it. So,
deagle power.
Yeah, put that clip in where you miss somebody at point blank range, mate. That was pretty good, yeah. Let's use that clip.
Well, again, we're going to see a flat-out rush from the T-side right now. They've been flashed out, and Aaron's in there.
Go big here. Oh, should have done better. They were all blind. And Critical going to put down the smoke. He's got the Galil now. Is that the next gun he needs to unlock an achievement for? Probably. But they have managed to get the bomb down here, Radical. So they might be able to take
some of this.
Critical just jumping, spraying away. Cookie Monster gets the kill, and that's going to be the defuse. 13 rounds to 2. Oh, the Zeus has come in. When Dante says, I'll be having that defuse. Look at his twitching.
Yeah, he's like,
amazing.
Oh.
And 13 to 2 at halftime. So Radical, slight improvement this time around. But at this rate,
doubled their score from last time.
Yeah, we need to play another 14, 15 games to get them to a place where they were competitive. Maybe. Is that how it works? I don't know.
We just put some bets on. Maybe your bet helped them edge that.
You
should have bet a little bit higher, Rich.
Mate, nothing's helping Hunger. Is he all right?
He's probably suffering from a bit of your abuse, and he now can't handle it anymore.
I don't think that, mate. If it's a UK online event, he's probably suffering from a crippling hangover. It is Sunday, isn't it?
Yeah.
day after Saturday.
They probably all looked at it and were like, really? Sunday, guys? Come on.
Yeah. Well, we go into another pistol round. Now, Radical, they have got a chance to salvage a bit of pride here if they can win this pistol round. You would think so anyway.
Cookie Monster with the jewelies. I'm liking the style already.
Well, if it's good enough for Envious, it's good enough for Infused. So let's see what's going to happen. And Infused are just going to be running into this mid area. They're not really giving too many cares about what sort of resistance they're running into. And you can see that Cookie Monster's just leading the charge. He's like, follow me, boys. Straight up on the highway. And he's trying to make the Julies work at distance, but he's getting absolutely wrecked by Campbell, who's just crouching up and down. And the Julies, so far, not being able to do too much damage. See, Hunger, he needs this kill. He does get it in the end. And Quig is going to answer back now as well with another kill. So this is actually a good position. 4-on-2 on the pistol round. It is Windansky. It is Zed. The bomb is going down on that B bomb site, which was left completely unattended. Radical knew they had to over-rotate to have any chance of forcing this. Zed is going to rip Robin's head off as he comes around the corner. MVP is going to go through the vents area. Just going to be dropping down now. So he's got that one call. You can see exactly where Windansky is as well. This is a great position for him. While they're trying to deal with Zed, it is going to be a 2-on-2. You can see Windansky's thinking about the knife here. So Zed is stopping them getting the defuse. Great position from him. He's going to get the headshot. Means that Quig's going to have to come off the defuse. They're running around and going for the knife action. Oh. Windansky's going to pick up the knife. It's going to be 14 rounds to 2. Radical Esports again. Throw away a good position. 4-on-2. Not for the first time in this series.
Yeah, it was in their favor for that slight bit, but they let the B-bomb site go completely, and it's never exactly what you want to let happen. You've got to think about this, even if Infuser just running at you with whatever guns they can get their hands on. Ooh. And Hunger straight out, but he was blind and being spammed. Aaron does away with him. Robin just missing every 5-7 shot there, and Aaron finishes him off. Quig does get one onto Zed, but it's still happening all over the map right now. Infuse going for the A bomb site. Critical wants this Zeus kill. Here we go. Oh, and he gets one. Tries to get the knife, but MVP shuts him down. Also taking down Aaron. It's all up to Windansky, and they've obviously got confidence that Windansky can pull this back in a 1v2.
Yep, he's going to be peeking from that car. He's going to get one the kill down. From Quig. He comes from Highway, so they know exactly where he is. But it's an interesting situation to be in. Windansky's got to get that bomb. What are you peeking for, son? MVP gives away his position. That could spell disaster, but he is going to get the kill. It is going to be 3 rounds for Radical. So, well done.
Here we go, Robin says. Robin believes in himself now, believes in the team.
I know, 3 whole rounds, and it actually puts Infused on an eco if you look at their money. So, going to have this Tech 9 and Deagle in the hands of Windansky by coming in. And what can Infused do with it now? This is a good opportunity for Radical to sort of make this scoreline a little bit respectable.
And Critical, he's got that Zeus again. He's keen on these Zeus kills right now.
And they've just been caught with their pants down there.
Trying to do the boost.
Trying to do the boost and left it a little bit too late. You've got to be so smooth and well-drilled. That said, Critical and Aaron are down to 5 and 6 HP apiece. That's going to be Aaron taken down by Quig. So even though the bomb is down and ticking away, you can see that Infused are getting chopped down to shreds here. Robin's going to get another kill. Zed's... Oh, he's got the long way around. They've planted that perfectly for him. Surely they can't win this now, Radical. So Robin's going to push Zed, just wasting time, takes his head off. 15 rounds to 3. And I was going to save this one, Banks, but I'm going to have to use it now because otherwise the game's going to be over. I was going to say, the way that Hunger played, you could say he's on Hunger Strike. Yeah?
Yes.
You're there?
Oh, like, no. Bless him.
Yeah, wrecked.
Well, the Rec Nines did win that round for Infuse there, despite them being on the eco side of it.
And yeah, to be fair, Radical should have won that, even with the delayed boost. Anyway, let's get this one closed out. Hunger is going to get the first kill here. You can see that they're on a bit of a forced buy, Radical. Aaron's going to pick up a cheeky double there with the AK. Zed spraying down through the smoke. He's fully expecting someone to come into his field of vision. Quig's going to get it. Campbell's going to answer back on a Cookie Monster with the Nova. 3-on-2. Campbell incredibly low. Critical trying to go for the Zeus. Wasn't at range. Campbell's going to get another Nova kill. Maybe he'll unlock an achievement. I don't think that's going to happen, actually. You need about 100 kills for that one, don't you? So,
yeah, very unlikely that they've even been practicing with that.
Yeah, I don't think so. So MVP Having a spam away.
Oh.
Don't peek, mate. Aaron's, he's 1.6. Yeah, he's going to tap you all day long. 2-on-1, Camel, incredibly low, trying to do something with the scout. Gets taken down. That is all she wrote. 16 rounds to 3 for Infuse. First map, 16-1. I was right. We didn't see overpass.
Sadly, we
didn't even see 5 rounds going the way of Radical. No.
Not at all. And, well, you got to feel sorry for Radical there. They were being messed around a little bit towards the end, but...
I don't know. I think it's all in the spirit of the game. And to be fair, Radical seem to be having a good time. Kyanite, some observations. I mean, I know it's hard because when you've got one team sort of running around trying to get Zeus kills, it's entertaining. But what can we sort of glean about how good Infused are for the rest of this tournament moving forward when they're going to face some stronger opposition?
Well, Infused, there's no doubt that they're a strong team, but personally, I just want to focus on Radical Gaming because this was meant to be their map. I mean, obviously, it was a stomp, but going back to the start of Cash where they were starting on the T side, their approach was completely incorrect. For example, you mentioned it, Richard, where they were getting caught out, all of them towards the B side of the map. And then Team Infused, we had Zed, who was just pushing A main, one person who was just pushing the doorway, and that gave Team Infused all the information and allowed them to also push mid and just flank them from behind. The Terrorists just weren't adapting sort of their attack. And when they were actually trying to execute onto the B bomb site, the reason why Critical was so good, and he got that 5-man with the AWP, which he shouldn't have got,
no,
without a doubt anyways, was because they weren't using smokes. Normally, the B bomb site, when you're on the T side of Cache, is quite an easy bomb site to take over because you use the wall, you smoke CT spawn, and you smoke the upper area. If you can put down a wall of smokes at mid and get vents control as well to get checkers, then that's it. But fundamentally, I don't want to sound biased or wrong, but everything Radical were doing was appalling, and it was just genuinely... this was meant to be their map. It looked like they've never played Cash before in their lives.
Well, I mean, you make a good point about the sort of fundamentals. You know, the flashes and the smokes weren't there. The only team you really saw utilising them were Infused, and, you know, again, you've got to give yourself a fighting chance by just doing... The fundamentals, the basics.
Yep.
You got to put a smoke down. You got to at least make the terrorists have to think.
And they would have heard this from us on Mirage, and they still didn't do it.
They still didn't do it.
They were paying attention to our bets.
They were joining in.
They loved the bets, but not the rest.
They were on the desk with us, practically. So it was fairly easy. Getting back to Infused, I mean, we knew they were a good outfit. I don't think Radical have really tested them too much there, but have you seen anything that maybe make you think, okay, Infused are on collision course with easy skins perhaps here, and they could be going all the way to the finals?
I think the thing about Infused, when Critical is chiming in and playing really, really well, the rest of the team play really, really well as well. Mm. I think one of the interesting things about this new side is obviously they Hoods G's retired and they brought in Windansky, who used to play with Weber, some of the current Easy Skins players, and we know him from back in Source where he was a phenomenal player, and we saw glimpses of it that game as well. So two great players, Zed as well, back in Source, people used to say he's one of the best UK upcoming talents, and right now, I think he has some of the best aim in UKCS as well. So when you match up the players individually, sure, it's there. But tactically, we're going to have to wait and see. But I think if we do end up seeing those two teams clash head-to-head, be it in the semis or maybe end up at EGX at the Gfinity Finals, I think the Team Infused, without a doubt, do stand a very good chance. And the fact that they have been together for a much longer lineup than Easy Skins is something that they can use to their advantage.
I know for a fact that Critical will be well up for that game as well. There's one thing he loves, it's sticking in the needle to his old UK teammates from back in the day. He knows how to wind people up, get inside people's heads. He's always got someone to prove. So, so far so good for Team Infused. Radical are going to be going home, even though they're at home.
Yeah.
But it was good to meet some new people. See you again next time.
Yeah, good bit of fun at least. And they joined in with us.
So I think we were able to bring up an updated bracket before we go to the break. Are we able to do that? Oh, I've just been told that we've still got games going on, so we'll bring that back after the break. So just some final thoughts. Anything you'd like to say to Radical, Kyanite?
Sort it out.
Right, James.
Buy a flash and a kit.
buy a kit. There you go, guys. They're pretty good items.
Yeah.
Might want to check them out.
Staples, yes.
Don't get achievements for them, but they're pretty good. Anyway, thanks for your thoughts, guys. We are going to throw it with a short break now. When we come back, we're going to be bringing you another one of our top picks from the action here at the Gfinity UK CSGO Championship. See you soon.
I'm on it.
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 Hello, folks. Welcome to Gfinity, Spring Masters number one for Counter-Strike.
His own and going for a counter smoke, trying to buy the time, but nothing catches Soxy, who is trying to go for the flank. This has just turned out into an all-out brawl, but it's a 2-on-3, and there's just no time for Cloud9. They have 15 seconds. They have to go here. They have to come in.
Oh, huge shot from Smith. Kirishima onto Shazam. Nothing. The last man left with 5 health, and it's all over.
Last round of the half, he gets one, but surely Team Immunity aren't going to throw this one away, or maybe they will. To existence with the hat trick, he's still got Imagine to try and deal with. He will pick up the AK-47. Oh,
he possibly can. Let's see if he can actually make that happen. Ooh, Azza with an attack there. And Chris Sloney moving in with all the nades, trying to play it safe still. JKS pick anything up here. Good damage there to Fugly. Finishes him off. This position's actually really good for JKS. Could spray down a couple more players. There's the second one. And the third one. Excellent stuff from JKS. And the remaining two are really weak here. This guy could be working on a massive clutch. Gets the next kill. It's just Adren left now for Liquid. Working on the ace. JKS has to find him. Oh, he gets the shot. Unbelievable stuff. This guy is so hot. So hot through the first map and into the second. What on earth do you do against that?
I have no words.
Run through Garage, so now they know that the rotation is coming through. They should be rotating that man fairly quickly. Sean Garage needs to haul, or it's Shroud, actually. He's going to get through back to CT. And there he goes. Boss him out, but guess what? Fight this going to hit two glorious headshots. What is that? Pre-aiming the angle. It just takes them out. Cloud9, no time to react.
I'm speechless.
What was that?
He just, like, flicked. That was, oh my god. That was unbelievable. He still had one more player to find and frag. But to just bring this back into this position, and he gets it with the headshot! And that will seal the deal for the first map. But what a way to finish it as well.
Just run in as four, let Happy lurk and see if he can pick something up. And if we can get in there as four, potentially they can overwhelm somebody quick. And there you go, get right in the corner. Forrest is going to open up with that AWP. Get right does not last, however.
Forrest doesn't get one with AWP. Can't get the second. Kirishima gets the better of him. Exist does manage to take down NBK though. And Happy, look at that. Does get one. Alu replies. 1v2 right now. Into a 1v1. Kirishima will be in this B bomb site. Capable of getting the bomb down. It's him versus Alu right now. Bash goes over and he's going to go for it. Oh, wow. He gets the better of Alu. What a risk. And how worthwhile was that for him?
Dead on the Freiburg. And guess what? Two guys are looking straight at him.
That was amazing from Get Right right there. Four straight kills. That was insane.
That was magical.
He just take down this there, but will he be able to hold it on his own?
JW recently, just beforehand, blanked Alu, only before he killed himself. Super careful, Forrest with the pistol. How many times have we said that? Nice shot from Forrest, picked up the AWP from the corpse from JW, so both AWPers have been down here. That's a flashbang, Pauth leaps on top of Get Right, we'll get that frag. 2-on-3, nice shot from Forrest, he's in a 1v2, he manages to actually land that first shot, and Forrest gets the clutch! Unbelievable play!
Длиной. Здесь уже есть первый минус. Смитс. Шикарный хедшот. С первой пули забирает места. Вау. Смитс. Шнейдер также отъехал. Смитс. Смитс.
Что делает этот парень?
Смитс. Это эйс. Просто невероятные 5 минусов.
Empty space, and even when the music is loud, I'd rather be no other place than here with you now. Here with you now.
This video is brought to you by G2A.com.
Today we faced Titan in a best of three. We won two games, two maps, lost one. Actual maps we won, we played really solid, we had good communication. It was just good.
We decided yesterday that I would call today and against Titan and maybe in the finals as we are in now.
We're all pretty tired from all the traveling, yeah. But yeah, we'll try to just push out that last bit of energy to just motivate each other. Sometimes it's hard, you get easily annoyed, aggravated, you know, because you're tired and exhausted from all the traveling and all the events we've had 5 weeks in a row.
The last few weeks we have been traveling, it's been really tough. We've been to the United States of America, we have been to Romania, we have been to all over the place, and this has been really tough on us, both mentally and physically. But we struggled the first day, but now we seem to be back on form, so I hope we will do well in the finals.
We had three draws and one win, and it's kind of amazing how we even went through the groups, considering that in the other group there were three teams with three wins and one loss, but that's how it is sometimes, you know, you get a bit lucky.
I'd prefer to play Virtus Pro, but it's the same, we should be the winners of either of the teams.
I think we're probably, would rather play VP than Na'Vi. Na'Vi's slow style kind of eliminates our aggressiveness and how we were able to take duels. But VP, they want to take duels as well, and that kind of suits our style better, I think. It doesn't really matter who we face. We'll prepare and hopefully give a good game anyways.
If you have an advantage, you should play the trades. But well, we're going to have Alu taking down Freeze at the start of the round again. So this is another situation where LAP should easily be able to just say, all right, guys, we want an early round kill. We can play with their rotation. We can play the trade game in the open areas of the map, and we should come out on top unless something ridiculous happens.
Okay, so there's an early advantage again here for NIP. This time, Alu's going to be the one in long, and he will find the second frag onto Acilian. At the moment, we are headed towards overtime two here in this battle of countries here. Swedes with a bit of help from Finland versus the Danes. Another frag. Alu going absolutely bananas. This is more than a bit of help. This is a mauling by Alu. Only Sandin remaining here. And unless he can go for some insane 1v5 clutch, we should be going to overtime too.
Yeah, so contention here to the various areas of the map for NIP at the moment, as far as looks for the entry here towards long. So forcing out some nades, and actually with the trajectory of that nade, Forrest would have spotted, he actually knows where they're standing, or at least one of the players
I think he heard them as well, because it was a bit of a shambles. They were trying to boost into the spot on the left, but they somehow failed to do it.
Oh, can't get it done. Nissalim will take the frag. So Alu, can he refrag here? They would desperately need something like a refrag here. Oh, goes for the shot. Manages to connect. Nissalim is going to go down, and Ali's going to push into the site. He thinks there's only two players around there, but there's one who's very close. Oh, he's going to get the drop on him. Takes down Tenski with a close range shot on the AWP. There's one more lurking. Alu finds it again. And it's going to be a really good situation on the A bomb site now, with Alu locking things down. But get right with the bomb. Challenges directly by the doors. Now Alu has to go up close. This could be a disaster here for Alu. He's got 30 seconds. He's going to smoke off the bomb, pick it up, gets out of there, and he can run this to the bomb site now. But this is a one on two, and he's picked up the orb. Can Alu get the ace and save the day for NIP?
Down goes the bomb, and the C2s are coming from the same direction. They want to double peek, it seems. Let's see, Alu going to get the first snap onto Berry. Only Sandin remaining with 32 HP. They're on opposite sides of the site. They're going to jump up, and Alu is going to annihilate him. The Alugator is here, and he's in the death roll there.
James, this guy is starting to really just heat up right now. This is absolute madness. He picked up an ace there in the most amazing way, and that's going to tie things up. And again, now Ali's starting to get warm.
Hello CSGO community, my name is Slope, and I have the pleasure to introduce TweeDay's Top 20 Highlights of 2014. On behalf of Mr. TweeDay himself, I would like to thank all of the viewers, donors, and of course, all of your support throughout the year. Your support is very much appreciated. But now, let's check out the top 20 most memorable and most amazing highlights of 2014.
A little bit too intricate, mowed down by a bulldozer, that is Neo. And golly, oh, you would have bet your house on him hitting that frag. Forrest picks him off. He is down in the end by Taz. They're a man to the good here, Virtus Pro, but... that is massive. But Snacks is walking around and just walking into Snacks Wonderland. He gets a double hat trick of frag. He waited, he waited, he waited, and then he finished off the job. You just had to wonder, when was he going to pull the trigger? And when he did, it was quite magnificent.
NIP raiding party on this A site in just a moment. He's the one with the bomb, in fact, and it's going to be a 5-on-3 in towards that A site. Pasha bound to see action any second now as Freiburg will come through. They ping out a flash. Pasha's flashed as well. That will allow Freiburg to round the corner, but it won't allow him to get any further. Pasha unleashes hell as NIP come back with two of their own. Exist claims two before Pasha gets his hat-trick. He gets the fourth. This is sensational play from Pasha. He's picked off by Get Right in the end, and then we'll get dropped by Snacks. And what you need in moments like this are big, big players, and Virtus Pro's big players are showing up.
Gonna see them actually go towards B, so kind of making the wrong call here, but they can't exactly know without checking. And in, and they come Apex with one already with the USP. There's number two, Apex at the back of the site causing havoc here. For Virtus Pro, they're losing so many players. And now we've got Bjarni and Pasha left. Apex with the quad kill. Oh my god.
We'll be right back.
not going to give him much of a warning. And Vladek have yet to start the rotation. Going in quickly. Now Crims needs to come out huge with frags. They are blind. Great flash there. Crims gets a third with the flames. They're going in and they're still blinded. Crims gets four and there's one more coming in. AZK with 10 health.
Nice.
What a round. The ace from Crims. Beautiful hold.
Side team Dignitas, they've got the smokes down to cut Cloud9 off, and in fact they're going for huge plays. Dupree triple spray runs through the smoke into CPL, and that shatters the defense. Cloud9 in a 2-on-4.
That bomb plant's already been happening for quite a while here. So Hiko and Sean, that's a good kill from Hiko, but they realize Dupree's still in there somewhere. They're going to try and go for it here. They want to go all in. Hiko comes in with another kill. And back to a 2-on-2. That bomb's so far ticked. They got to move quick right now. They're going for it. The defuse is already happening. Hiko, are you kidding me? He's going to go for it. They win the round. Hiko picks up a triple and Cloud9 win it. What?
So he tried to solo fake, as now they'll rush it inside the B site. Crims is going to rotate around from the vents, though. He's already got two, one on Nitro in middle, and a second one on that rotate on AZK. So Adren's all by himself now. He does pick up that AWP. He does have the bomb, but he's going to Molotov off on the vents. He knows, though, that he's still got issues at B main, and there he's going to get JW. So good awareness as he rotates around, and he's still got a bit of an opportunity to get back into this round as they waited out in vents, but now they're going to come through as that Molotov has gone away. He knows they're there. He peeks out. Can't get in the first shot, although he does hit a huge shot on Crims up close. So now it's a one-on-one. Unbelievable. The player who I've been calling out for not exactly pulling his weight comes through at an absolutely pivotal moment right there. Highlight stuff from Adren, and that's going to give them one more round. They're stealing victory from the jaws of defeat right now.
Change. Not often that we see Shox actually go for the AWP. Inferno, at least. So this is basically Titan changing things up. They're going to flash their way through the smoke, and now it's going to come down to Shoxy. He's going to get caught in the corner, though. Gets a running shot on a Neo. Gets a second one. Shoxy's making it happen. A third one. Shoxy. The fourth. Shoxy is a god. The ace. What did we just witness? Furnace Pro get obliterated.
We'll be right back.
Legends win.
There onto Seuss, he does find the kill, spots another player. Wow, great shot there from Existence, takes down the second. Oh, gets the triple as well. Starlux falls to the ground and he's gonna pick up the AWP. Can he do this? He's got Guardian to play. Oh, Existence through the box, takes down Guardian, and now he can plant the bomb behind the smoke. Existence goes crazy into the ace and he gets the ace. Existence, can you believe it? This man, the caller of Titan.
They'll still be able to afford whatever for the last round, and this is going to be really crucial now what happens here on catwalk.
There's Freiburg.
Freiburg! Both kills! Adrian comes in and Freiburg with three! This is it! He gets the spray! Freiburg, they finally shut him down, but it's a one-on-three! Fantastic play, the entry fragger at his best! And Forrest does it! Nip go to the finals! Na'Vi! What now?
Now that we can also say, okay, we may be behind, but it's just that one round. As long as we can keep picking them up, we'll just do something else in the next round if we're limited on money, whatever. And there you go. JW once again picks up the kill on Kenny S.
Fantastic.
It really seems like the T-op is the most powerful weapon here right now on Inferno, Anders.
Just changes. Could go either way, but he's got the angle right through the smoke. Absolutely beautiful, and that's another bit opening kill here.
And he's going to get into position from pit as well, and this is such a difficult position to get him out of.
This, and they have a second member here at the bomb site, and there's already a rotation happening. Fnatic are actually in a horrible spot right now. As long as Titan stay cool, they're going to be fine. Oh, what a sick shot, and oh my god, JW, he gets the second one. He's looking for the ace. He's got just seven bullets, and he's going to go for it in the corner. Now it's a one-on-one. He misses that shot. There's 25 seconds left, and he's got six health. He's going to go with the CZ. Spray's here. Existence trapped in the corner. Now 20 seconds.
What?
He gets the ace. Are you kidding? Oh my god, Fnatic, they win that round.
Get out, JW.
be Caron now, who's getting two kills or just the one, but still manages to clear up the site. It's a 1v2. He goes for the smoke, and he's going to be holding on it. And LDLC, are they in position to stop it? They're going to miss! 3D Max!
Wonderful. The knife comes through, but it's too late.
But Existence is certainly in a decent position to start something off, but... Oh, this is...
He's got a knife.
Please knife him. Please knife him now. What are you waiting for? Please.
Yeah, 8 seconds left. Lannister, send their regards. Revenge there.